हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी लर्न अबाउट दी कार्बन एसिमिलेशन। कार्बन फिक्सेशन और कार्बन एसिमिलेशन इज द कन्वर्शन प्रोसेस ऑफ इनऑर्गेनिक कार्बन दैट इज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड टू ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड बाय लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म। एंड द मोस्ट प्रोमिनेंट एग्जांपल ऑफ कार्बन एसिमिलेशन इज फोटोसिंथेसिस। कीमोसिंथेसिस इज अनदर एग्जांपल ऑफ कार्बन फिक्सेशन दैट कैन take place in the absence of sunlight. Generally, there are three modes of carbon dioxide assimilation. First is C3 cycle or Calvin cycle or reductive pantose phosphate cycle. Second is the C4 cycle or Hatch and Slack cycle or dicarboxylic acid cycle. And the third one is crassulation acid metabolism. Now we see the photosynthetic pigments and their role. A photosynthetic pigment is a pigment that is present in chloroplast and it captures the light energy which is necessary for photosynthesis. These are the photosynthetic pigments. The main photosynthetic pigment is chlorophyll, which absorbs blue and red light and it provides green color to plants. Chlorophyll is divided into chlorophyll A, which provide bluish green color, and chlorophyll B, a yellowish green pigment. Second photosynthetic pigment is carotenoid, that is a type of accessory pigment. It absorbs purple light and contains three type of pigment, that is xanthophyll, a yellow pigment, carotene, orange pigment, and pheophytine, which provide gray or brown color. Now we see role of these photosynthetic pigment. First one is chlorophyll. Chlorophyll absorb light most strongly in the blue portion of the electromagnetic spectrum as well as the red portion. It is a poor absorber of green and near green portion of the spectrum, which is reflect producing the green color of chlorophyll containing tissues. Two types of chlorophyll exist in the photosystem of green plant, that is chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. The primary pigment of photosynthesis is chlorophyll A. Chlorophyll B is an accessory pigment because it is not necessary for photosynthesis to occur. Chlorophyll A absorbs light from the orange, red and violet blue area of the electromagnetic spectrum. It transfers energy to the reaction center and donates two excited electrons to the electron transport chain. The central role of chlorophyll A is as a primary electron donor in the electron transport chain. And on the other hand, chlorophyll B absorbs blue light. And the central role of chlorophyll B is to expand the absorption spectrum of organism. This is the structure of chlorophyll. Now we see the carotenoids. Carotenoids are yellow, orange and red organic pigments that are produced by plants, algae, bacteria and fungi. Carotenoids give the characteristic color to pumpkins, carrot, corns, and tomatoes. Carotenoids serve two key roles in plants and algae. First, they absorb light energy to use in photosynthesis and they provide photoprotection via non-photochemical quenching. Now we see the type of carotenoids and its role. First one is xanthophyll. It is a yellow pigment of leaves which absorb the wavelength that chlorophyll cannot absorb. It serves as protection to excessive amount of sunlight to prevent further damage in the plant. Second is carotene. These are orange photosynthetic pigments found in plants and play an important role in photosynthesis. It transmits the light energy that is absorbed from chlorophyll
and it also protects the plant by absorbing the energy of the light oxygen produced during the photosynthesis. And the last pigment is pheophytine. It is a chemical compound that reserves as the first electron carrier intermediate in the electron transfer pathway of photosystem 2 in plants. This pigment is mainly found in brown algae and purple bacteria. Now we see the antenna molecules and reaction center. Antenna molecules are also called light harvesting complexes. All functional pigments in photosynthetic membranes are bound in a variety of pigment protein complexes. In general, photosynthetic pigment and pigment protein complexes serve two primary functions. They function either as antenna or as reaction center. The antenna of plant consists of large amount of protein-bound pigment molecules which absorb photon and transfer their energy to the reaction center. These light harvesting complexes are formed by polypeptide which bind chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, carotene and xanthophyll. For photosynthesis, there are photosystems. Photosystems are functional and structural units of protein complexes involved in photosynthesis that together carry out the primary photochemistry of photosynthesis, that is the absorption of light and the transfer of energy and electrons. Photosystems are found in the thylakoid membranes of plant, algae and cyanobacteria. There are two types of photosystem. Photosystem 2 and photosystem 1. When photosystem 2 absorbs light, electrons in the reaction center chlorophyll are excited to a higher energy level and are trapped by the primary electron acceptor. Now, this photo-excited electrons travel through the cytochrome complex to photosystem 1 via an electron transport chain set in the thylakoid membrane. When the electron reaches photosystem 1, it fills the electron deficit of the reaction center chlorophyll of photosystem 1. ATP is generated when the ATP synthase transports the photon present in the lumen to the stroma through the membrane. The electrons may either continue to go through the cyclic electron transport around photosystem 1 or pass via ferredoxin to the enzyme NADP reductase. Now we see the electron transfer chain, which is also called ETC. ETC is a series of complexes that transfer electrons from electron donors to electron acceptor via redox reaction and couples this electron transfer with the transfer of protons across a membrane. This creates an electrochemical proton gradient that drives the synthesis of ATP, a molecule which stores energy chemically in the form of highly stained bond. There are two types of electron transport mechanism. First is non-cyclic electron flow and second is cyclic electron flow. Non-cyclic electron flow is the normal process of photophosphorylation in which the electron expelled by the excited photocenter and does not return to it. It is carried out in the collaboration of both photosystem 1 and 2. In this process, electrons are released by the photolysis of water, thus constant supply of water is needed. Here we see the diagram of non-cyclic electron flow. In this electron flow, electrons flow from water to reduce NADP to NADPH. In this process, first of all, photosystem 2 absorbs light and promotes to the excited state. In excited state, electrons acquire large amount of energy and move primary acceptor Q. Electrons from Q pass into the PQ. The reduced form of PQ donates electron cytochrome where ATP is formed. The electrons then pass to the plastocyanin and then to photosystem 1. The electrons from photosystem 1 expelled to excited state, from it moves to the ferredoxin protein. Ferredoxin protein transfer the electron to the NADP that reduce to NADPH. So this is the non-cyclic electron flow. Now we see the cyclic electron flow. It only involves photosystem 1. It usually occurs in the thylakoid membrane. The electron begins in a pigment complex called photosystem 1 in cyclic electron flow. It then further passes from the primary acceptor to ferredoxin to eventually to cytochrome. The electron then passes to plastocyanin before returning to chlorophyll. A proton motion force is produced throughout this electron transport chain, which pump hydrogen ion across the membrane and produces a concentration gradient that can be used to power ATP synthase during chemoosmosis. It neither produces oxygen or NADPH. So energy is produced in photosynthesis by these cyclic and non-cyclic phosphorylation. Thank you.